Hey, what's up, guys? This is Oakley, and you're going to be witnessing a massive assault on Karak, Hirn. And so it's going to be myself and Pixelated Apollo defending as the dwarves. We have multiple plazas secured, Iron Drake's killing field set up at all the gates. But we're going to be playing against Warrior of Sparta and Alex the Rambler, both going to be coming in with just tons and tons of high-tier units. And we'll see who comes out on top. We do have heroes stationed on the right, our own grudge throwers tossing rocks at the opponents, but they have so much coming at us. Our core lords are all along the wall here, not going to do much to penetrate the thick hide of these towers as they move into position. You'll notice that the enemy has tons of infantry. They have, I think, 4 or 5 spiders, same number of trolls, same number of giants, flying heroes. They have tons of savage orcs. They have black orcs, so this is a mighty, mighty WAAAAGH. And we'll see if we can withstand this. Sieges do obviously play a bit different in Total War Warhammer. It's much, much quicker. The strategy is much simpler. It's all about rushing, which is very suitable to the Greenskin playstyle. Battle begins immediately, and there's not too much to fall back on, although in this battle we're going to be trying to see if we can't pull a defense in depth off. Meanwhile, you have the Flight Academy here, students taking their inaugural classes. This is how they learn to fly, and sadly, well, I guess you become an expert on the first try. You can see the goblins here cheering as they take off, and this has got to be my favorite unit in the entire game. Just so cool. So there they go, using flying corpses to batter the walls. Now, we have our own flying aces who know a little bit better how to navigate through the air and have a little bit better longevity. And these guys are going to be coming out, so they are going to be flying up here past the enemy. The enemy has essentially all melee infantry, so what that means is essentially we can just fly right up to them and just start bombarding them, firing away. But with the thick armor of the enemy, it's going to take a long time to try punching through here. We're going to be targeting the key units, but at this point the enemy has tons of good units, and so every unit is could be deemed key, and it's only a matter of time before they charge up to the wall. So here they're already getting out of our line of fire. This is going to be pretty bad if we can't take out more units. We're going to continue to chase them, but those black orcs really not losing any forces, and now they're essentially all up and down the wall on all fronts. The Arachnorok's getting up close to the walls as well, and now they're going to start to unload as well. This is not looking good for the dwarves. So what we decided to do this battle is trying to do a defense in depth. So instead of putting all our units up at the front walls, we have a couple skirmishers, a couple melee infantry, and then the rest we've kind of stationed rather further in the back at the killing fields that we've deployed. We'll see if that pays off. So the enemy is essentially going to come up here uncontested and just start hacking away at our guys. These are all black orcs, big guns, so not much we can do. We've already pulled back a bunch of our guys. You can see the crossbowmen pulling back, handgunners pulling back. What we want to do is start shooting units on the walls, which was pretty effective in previous Total War games. We'll see how it is in this one. Meanwhile, the enemy is up at the gates. They do have some of the trolls hammering away at it, and they've been able to do enough damage such that it is now going to be blasted open. And this is going to open up the floodgates to all kinds of monsters. Trolls on the one hand would seem pretty big, but in comparison to what's coming through this gate, yeah, we have a lot coming at us. So this is going to be one of our killing fields. So yes, it looks intimidating for what's coming at us, but we have a lot of defenses. A dwarf warrior is going to be charging slayers, and then we have iron breakers, iron drakes, miners with blast charges taking flanking positions on this. So as the enemy is clumped up, we're going to hold them steady and unload on them. You'll see that here shortly. Nonetheless, a lot of dwarf warriors are paying dearly with their lives, but here goes the carnage. And I do have to say, the explosions in this game are freaking beautiful against these big targets here when they get, and that is just horrific. The giants not taking a cue, continuing to eat guys. Oh, and look at that dude on the right, just unfazed. He threw up a little bit because of that explosion, but just like a Hollywood badass, did not look back. these giants on fire, continuing to eat the dwarves, basically using our explosive charges to get a nice little crisp on the dwarves before they eat them. Oh my god, this is so ridiculous. So they've poured everything through there. That is three giants, an arachnarok, and two trolls, troll units. So that's a lot of guys. More miners with blasting charges moving up. We need all the explosive firepower up at the gate. Same thing is going to be happening here. Giants moving forward. We're going to commit the slayers. Thorgrim Grudgebearer basically wrote a little grudge. Oh, you owe me for breaking that gate. And here we're going to repay the grudge, or try and seek vengeance for the grudge. So our units here firing away. Slayers trying to hold up against this giant. And now here comes the blast charges. Ooh! Iron Drakes, flame cannons, everything firing. Look at this continuous, just, that is a volcanic eruption unleashed on that giant. So much firepower. Just crazy. The giant is down to half health, rapidly dropping, but still he's going to push through to our other ranks. So this just shows how strong those guys are. Meanwhile, while we're focusing fire, the rest of the units are pouring through. We have two Arachnaroks and more giants coming in there, even more troops in the back coming in. So this is, they've battered down the walls and are hitting us with a sledgehammer at this point. Some goblin fanatics just tearing through the ranks, and then Azag, the slaughter on the top left there on his wyvern, casting spells, just going to town on our force here. We're continuing to blow them up with blasting charges, but it's, oh god, these beasts just have so much health. It is crazy. And it's Warrior of Sparta commanding Azog on this flank. Black Orc's going to be pouring forward too, and we're forced to pull back some of our units. Azag going to be throwing himself into that fight to clean up the remaining guys. Yeah, this is pretty devastating. The next plaza there is where we're going to try and hold out. Another plaza here we're also holding out. Great Axes, Quarrelers, other units here, just at all the choke points. We're trying to defend more and more. So the Savage Orcs are coming in. We're going to greet them with these Dwarf Warriors with Great Axes and whatnot. Look at the stature differential fighting these guys. Jeez, talk about an uphill fight. This is crazy. The Black Orcs have seized the top, and here they're pushing forward. Iron Drakes just hosing these guys, but still taking a lot of enemy fire, actually from the Flight Academy pilots targeting us here. Incredible range on the Doom Diver, so they're sniping our high value targets, but we are able to rout one of the Arachnaroks, so that's a nice turnaround for us. But again, there's another one waiting in the back. Oh god, so much stuff. And a giant gonna say, I don't care what you throw at me, I'm gonna continue to push through. So he goes all the way to our targets in the rear and take out the Iron Drakes. And then more giants, and the Doom Diver's coming in. Just chaos on the 360 degrees, all levels of the battlefield. Crazy stuff. And that giant gives no fucks. He's just gonna keep running through, and this is gonna be the cue for Thorgrim Grudgebearer to get on out of there. Meanwhile, the rest of our dwarves are gonna try and hold the forces back so he can make his escape, but they're gonna pay dearly for that. We have spellcasters here, goblin shamans casting spells on us, and that was in large part what was kind of starting to destroy our forces on this front. So we're pulling back with almost everything. Fall back! Fall back! Is what is being shouted on the battlefield right now. We have our next choke point set up. Thunder is going to be setting up slayers on the flank, iron breakers with projectiles, and then we have the flame cannon as well. So dang, we have a lot of stuff set up. The far left flank is being taken to task, being killed. Ooh, and look at that giant corpse. So this is perhaps where we can draw a line in the sand, a line in the dirt, and hold them. Thunder is going to start unleashing on that Arachnarok spider while it munches on our comrades. You just saw it there spit up some armor from a dwarf. So, oh god, this is very, very bad news for the dwarves. More of our forces are going to be streaming back to the final, or second to last choke point. And uh-oh, it looks like we've caught the attention of the Arachnorok spider, which is still at 75% health. Oh, let's hope the field guns can take him out. Thunder is going to be focusing fire, but that Arachnorok has some pretty crazy charge. Look at this as it winds itself up. Boom! Just smashes through our line. And now we're going to hit it from multiple flanks. Iron Drakes flaming it. The gunners, we're going to have blasting charges soon. Everything is going to be directed at this Arachnorok. Slayer's also going to be coming in. So doing everything right, but still that spider not going to be going down. Crazy strong units. Oh my god, the charges on that thing is crazy. They just dart through anything, and the mass on this thing alone is hard to stop. It is exhausted and losing decisively. Now it's wavering, so we may actually have close to our first kill on an Arachnorok. Ironbreaker is expending almost all their ammunition to take. Bring her down, bring her down, bring her down. Really wish there would be an awesome kill animation for Ungrim or one of the dwarf lords or something to like mount the spider and plant an axe in its head. Some really cool animation would be sick to see, execution style. Over here, you thought we had trouble dealing with one spider. Well, what about two spiders? Can I get a third? Can I get a fourth spider? No, I'll give you a giant. So, oh my god, this is a crazy uphill fight for us. And yes, we've set up tons of choke points, but even the fire not doing away with these guys. And if we try and commit anything up close to chop, hack away at their ankles and their legs, well then they have black orcs to get our guys, spellcasters. So, oh god, not a good day to be a dwarf. But this is the power of the WAAAGH. Slayers up through here are holding, committing themselves to an honorable, glorious death, holding back 5-6 units at a time, allowing our guys to reform and start firing. And look at the mass of guys they're holding back, but it's not gonna be enough. They're gonna start swarming around past them, coming up towards the flame cannon. We're gonna get some nice flanking shots on this force, and we're gonna have to charge in with some of our dwarf warriors to keep holding them. Doom Divers still coming in, and they're just destroying our guys. Blast charges coming in. Oh god. As a bit of a report on sieges, I do find that they are pretty fun. I mean, you can't deny that this is awesome, epic stuff. But in terms of functionality, this is going to be essentially a rush. Oh my god, the Foot of Gork just wiping out the Iron Breakers unit. That is going to be a pivotal moment on this flank. But like I was saying, the sieges here, basically we decided not to contest the walls, and you saw how that was really not to our advantage. We really need to score as many kills with the towers as possible, and by not doing so, you can see just how devastating that has been to our forces. And so it seems like as a defender, your only strategy is to defend the walls. And as an attacker, well, you're under fire from the beginning, so your only strategy is to storm all the walls at once. So I can see replayability not being so great in the future. Nonetheless, I mean, that doesn't detract from how epic this battle in and of itself is. I just worry a bit about the longevity and replayability of such battles, especially when all the sieges play the same. Oh god, we're getting bombarded here. This is just not fair. And it looks like my miners here are out of blasting charges. They would have loved to toss some more into this hefty pile of black orcs who are shaken and tired, but it's not going to be the case. This plaza holding out okay, I guess. All the black orcs going to be focusing their fire on the iron drakes on the right flank because they know how much damage that's doing, but our flame cannon still chewing away at these guys. And they're swarming like ants over the bodies of the giants and their comrades. Nothing can stop the spirit of this WAAAGH. Crazy. And these black orcs are not to be trifled with. Incredibly strong units, super expensive, but they pack a punch for their cost. Extremely strong, high in armor. They can tank losses like that. And when you have spiders to tank out even more damage for them, they are nigh on unstoppable. I did save one grudge thrower in the back here, hoping to try and take out some of the giants and other units at a distance, but this spider is unfazed. Here comes Thorgrim Grudgebear, trying to stop the spider, but he gets... Oh, spider's like, where'd he go? He just gets completely run over. And it's really hard to use Thorgrim against giants like this giant units like this, because they can just run out of his grasp, and he's really not doing any damage against it. The spider just seemingly unfazed. Meanwhile, while we've turned our attention on that spider, everything else is going to be flying in from all of their flanks. I'm not going to bring my hero. Ungrim Iron Fist is going to be coming in. Flame Cannon also being pulled in to try and suppress the center, but that means we've detracted firepower from this side, which could be our undoing, but we have to hold the middle. Oh man, this spider not going down. Hammer is trying to squash a bug, but I think you're gonna need a bigger hammer to do that. Oh god. More spiders. Now we have four spiders in the plaza, plus a giant, plus unknown black orcs, which would be bad enough by themselves. The giant just like, whoa, having an existential crisis or something. Not sure what to do. He's just, oh man. Either he says I'm getting too old for this, or he's just savoring the moment. No, we did kill one of the spiders. Good job, hammers. Flame Cannon has been relieved of the spider. Spider is now routing, and so now it can unload on these other remaining units. This is our only hope to take these guys down. Maybe get a mass route now that our heroes are committed. We'll see, but so much pressure is coming out, and the left has buckled. Only one final hammer unit holding strong, but more Orc War Boy big guns. Tons of units coming in. Oh god, this is bad. The right flank with the shamans buffing their units is also going to be breaking. The gunners in the back going to be not doing enough damage. Oh, jeez. Sad day to be a stunty here. And I do think, balance-wise, that the Arachnarok and the Giants are just super powerful, really hard to take out in scenarios like this. I mean, you can see how much damage we've been putting on them the entire game, and they are not going down. Not quite sure how to take them out cost-effectively. It could be the Trollhammer torpedoes that we were missing, but honestly, I'm not sure what to do against this, which again results in the only scenario really where you can win these sieges, is I think if you hold the enemy at the gates and outside the walls, because the towers are the only really saving grace for your army that can do a lot of damage. But anyways, the plaza is now belonging to the enemy, and the further depths of the Karak await this WAAAGH, but really all of our warriors are dead, so there is almost no hope left. Yep, every single dwarf is gone, except for one. Ungrim still in the fight, and he is fighting a spider mano e mano. This is the definition of a dwarven slayer king, the last man standing in a Karak. Oh god. The Greenskin's coming here to teabag his body as he's on the ground, adding insult to injury. Oh god, I don't think he's long for this world. Look how many guys are coming in at him. This is the sum total of a WAAAGH. Just crushing one man, and here comes the Wyvern as well. Oh god. I think he's down for the count. No, he's picked himself back up. Turn around and smack Azog. Lop off his head. Oh my god, this is ridiculous. Oh, and down he goes. I think that is it. Yeah, he's been taken out. So, admittedly, they do say it is a close defeat, but it seemed rather lopsided and one-sided. Either way, very, very fun battle, very entertaining, super thematic. The explosions, the chokeholds, all really interesting, but I think it does kind of belie some fundamental problems with the sieges. But time will only tell. We'll see. Strategy is hold the walls, hold the walls, hold the walls. And I did, you know, admittedly, we didn't have the top level towers. They were only level, I think, one or two. So I think 3 or 4 might be necessary. But you can see the final kills here. So Rambler and Warrior of Sparta just destroyed myself and Pixelated Apollo. We had more men, but they had more giants, Arachnarok spiders, all kinds of huge units. And the rest of their infantry was all Black Orcs and Big Guns. Yeah, not much we could do to fight that off. We did our best, but at the end of the day, just got pounded into the ground. And I do have to say, I kind of dislike how CA has continue to withhold the kill stats for the armies here, and when it's a huge settings like this, you can't even see the individual kills on units. So that's kind of a letdown to see here at the end of the battle. I would have liked to see who got the most kills. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed. Check out these other videos for more awesome content. See you in the next one. Peace out.